Welcome to the plan management module. In this video, we will walk you through the plan building process. A plan defines the hierarchy and order of work activities that must be completed for a project, program, or product. The structure provides a means of breaking down complex projects into manageable components. In large projects, one individual might define a top-level plan structure, and then several individuals might supply the detailed breakdown for activities. So, let's begin creating a project. We will name the project as Project 1. Select the template reference as General. Click OK to create a project. When we create a project, one of the plans is created by default. You can observe that the Project 1 plan is created with the milestones Project Start and Project Finish. Let's build the plan. The plan building process includes the following activities: how to create plan activities and child activities, how to assign users for activities, how to schedule constraints, how to execute the plan. Let us create activities and child activities for project phases such as requirement, design, development, and sign-off. To create a new activity, click New Activity or right-click Project Start and select Insert Activity below. A new activity page opens. Name the activity as Requirement and click Finish. Now, let's define the requirements and conduct review meetings during the requirement phase. For this, create child activities under the requirement activity. Let's create a child activity to define requirements. Right-click requirement and select Insert Activity as the child option. Name it as defined requirements, provide the duration as 5 days, and click Finish. Similarly, let's create one more child activity to conduct a requirement review meeting. Schedule it as soon as possible because we want to start it as soon as the defined requirements activity is complete. Enter 3 as predecessors because the requirement activity ID is 3 and provide 1 day duration for this activity. In the same way, create an activity and child activities for the design phase. Similarly, let's create an activity and child activities for the development phase. We want the development activity to start only in the next month. For this, schedule it as Start No Earlier Than and select the date and then click Finish. Thus, the activity will not start before the specified constraint date. Again, we will create child activities for the development phase. Let's create the activity to sign off the project. We want this activity to start as late as possible. Create the activity, select the as late as possible option, provide the duration, and then click Finish. The activity will be scheduled for the last day of the project with the duration of 1 day. Now, let's provide the predecessor for the Project Finish activity. We have created all the activities and child activities. Here, you can view the duration, estimated start date, estimated finish date, and predecessors for each activity. Now, assign these activities to a specific user. Right-click the activity, select the Assign Resources option, and click OK. To execute the plan, right-click the plan, and click Edit. From the execution control menu, you can select the manual or automatic option. Let's select automatic and click OK. Now select the plan, right click and click start execution. With this, we are done building a plan. Thanks for watching the video.